So let's now define, what does it mean for caches to be coherent? Intuitively, they're coherent when the whole thing behaves like there was no caches, but let's define more precisely what exactly does it mean. There are three requirements for coherence. The first one says that the read, let's call that read R, from some address X on some core C1, will return the value written by the most recent write, let's call that write W, to the same location, and that write was on the same core C1, if no other core has written to that location between the accesses W and R. So this first part of the coherence definition really says that if one core is operating on a location alone, then its reads should be getting the most recent writes from the same core. This basically says that a coherent behavior includes correct uniprocessor behavior as long as the location is accessed by only one core. The second part of the definition says that if core C1 writes to a location X and C2 reads X after a sufficient time, and if there are no other writes that happen in between C1's write and C2's read, then C2's read must return the value C1 wrote. So pretty much if there is a write and the read happens sufficiently after that write, then the read has to read what the write wrote, except if there was another write in between, in which case the read is allowed to return that value instead of this one. So this part of the definition really prevents the case when, for example, C1 writes something to its own cache, C2 reads forever from its cache a stale value. To be coherent, if C1 writes, then after some sufficient time, C2 must start reading the new value, even if maybe a normal cache with no coherence support would just keep reading the stale value because it never gets replaced. So we have to do something in order to make this part of the definition work for private caches that are caching data in a coherent system. So we must do something to make these caches behave this way. And finally, the third part of the definition says that if there is more than one write to the same location, then these writes must be serialized. That is, any two writes to the same location must be seen to occur in the same order on all the cores. What this part of the definition really says, different cores should not be able to disagree about which write occurred first and which occurred second. Note that the second part of the definition doesn't really require this to happen. Let's say there was one write on C1 and another write on C3. When C2 reads, it's allowed to return after a sufficient time either C1's or C3's value because it's allowed to interpret this order as either C1 and then C3 wrote or the other way around. What this part of the definition says is that whatever C2 sees, if C2, for example, sees that the final value is that from C1 and not from C3, then all the other cores when they read that location after C2 need to also see that order. So it cannot happen that C2 thinks C1 wrote last, some other core sometime later reads and still sees C3's value. So what this is really saying is that everybody, including the writing cores, will see the value that is consistent with there being some particular order to the writes. It doesn't require any particular order. For example, the writes can happen almost simultaneously, in which case we are free to choose which happened first and which happened second, but we cannot allow some cores to think that one write was first and other cores think that another write was first.